I hope that the people who come to the wedding get an insight and get a feel for mine and Alison's relationship, because when I feel mine and Alison's relationship, I feel alive, and I hope that when people come to our wedding, they feel that life too.
Talking about it now, I feel really excited. I am really looking forward to it, and I've got an image in my mind of how I think it'll be, but I know that it will probably be even more special than that, because I feel like that what I'll feel that day will be a feeling that I've never ever felt in my life, and I probably never will never feel again. So that's really exciting to be sort of, you know, experiencing something completely unique.
It's almost going to be like a landscape of my 32 years on this planet, seeing where I've come from, where I've been, where I am now, the sort of people that I've chosen to be part of my life, be part of my path, be part of my journey. My journey. My journey.
I think this is a fantastic idea, doing this, and I feel very honoured to be sitting here. It's a beautiful place that you've chosen to get married. I think it's absolutely lovely. When I saw it, I just couldn't believe it. And I'm so thrilled for both of you. The ceremony was absolutely delightful, and the way you spoke to each other was really touching, because you could really tell that you meant it, and that's what it's all about. I just feel really moved to be here. I'd like to have been a bit later so I could have had a couple of drinks, obviously, and then I might speak a bit more clearly, or not, as the case may be. But I just want to say that, Alison, you are a dear friend to me. I don't think you know how much you mean to me and how special you are, but you are such a lovely person. You're so warm and friendly and giving, and just so special. And I'm not just saying that, I'm not being mushy. You are just so lovely. And I'm so honoured to be your friend and that you make time for me in your life, and I mean that. And Paul, I don't know you as well as I know Alison, but I know that you make her very, very happy, and that is very important. And I know that you do lovely things for each other, and you know that you're a great guy, basically. I don't know you as well as Alison, and I wish I did, but hopefully one day we might write that. And that's it really at the moment.
Goodness, I can't really say what I'm going to say without crying. I can't cry for the next 2 minutes. Just, that really just explains all about how I feel about Alison and Paul and how special they are to me. And how, I don't know really. Just how lucky I feel just to be here and part of everything. And they're just such a wonderful couple and just wonderful friends. I can't think of anything else except I'd like to be in this bedroom, really, because it's much nicer than my chalet. And I've noticed there's a bath and I haven't got a bath. So if you don't mind, I'm going to move into the diary room tonight.
I think today has been great. I think it's been very emotional. Reminded me of Lou and our vows, and I'm sure you'll be very happy together. That's it.
I had obviously the job this morning of making Alison look beautiful, and quite frankly, it was very difficult. No, that's not true. She looked absolutely sparkling before I put anything on, and it was just so lovely to be part of that and doing that. And I'm very glad I bought her the breath freshener tablets, because she did need it this morning, desperately need those. And what else do I need to say about, well, it was lovely being there also with Sharky and Alison together, because they're such lovely friends, and they're just, it's like, oh God, I'm going to cry again. It's just like watching two people who are so special to each other. Just feel very privileged to be part of that. And I think, God, I've not even had a drink yet, and I'm all terribly emotional. What else was so lovely, being part of there and to meet Alison's mum and her sister. And it's just all very, very special.
Paul is a very, very warm person, and he's quite difficult to get to know, but once you know him, he is a top banana bloke.
Oh, right, I'm a little bit breathless to start with, because I've been running, because I know Chris is on a very tight schedule, so I've raced up the stairs, and obviously because of my smoking habits, I'm very, very breathless. But I just want to say that I'm having an absolutely super time, and I feel so lucky and honoured to be both of your friends. And it's so special that you're getting married today. And I couldn't think of two more perfect people together. You're my best friends, and I love you both very much.
Well, I got married 2 years ago, and it's a bit strange because you sort of go through the day. I went through the day not realising what was going on, and today it's actually good to stand back and actually see what happens. Plus the fact that it's just so tremendously emotional today, it's bizarre. I just haven't stopped blotting. I've been blotting for about, you know, 20 minutes during the ceremony itself, and it's just tremendously touching.
I just wanted to say also about the ceremony, and I'm just presuming that you both sort of designed the words, because they were just so you, and just it would describe both of you so much that it was just so perfect. And I couldn't see the sea from where I was standing. I obviously wanted to push my way to the front so I could see the sea and everything, but I got all the images in my mind, and it was just so beautiful and very lovely.
I think the nicest thing so far for me today is that when Alison walked into the room where you were about to both get married, the sun immediately came out, which obviously brought tears to my eyes. And I think you both look absolutely beautiful, especially Alison.
Well, with Jenny and I, we've always had this union, But when it actually, you know, the event, the wedding itself, and, you know, the, you know, it sort of brings a formality to it, but at the same time, it just, if you like, it confirms and, you know, it distills the whole sort of process, if you like, into this essence. And from that point on, you don't think about things in a different way. You think about things, you know, like you have. We were together for 10 years or so, but there's this great comfort, you know, there's a union there, but it's, everything's more relaxed. You've just got this, you know, this constant comfort that, you know, everything's fine, everything's going to be good, all the rest of it. It's bizarre.
Hello, Mr. and Mrs. Reaney. Just want to say thank you very much for inviting me to your beautiful, beautiful wedding. This is the first wedding, obviously, that I've been to with all of you, and I've had such a lovely day. And apart from the fact that I've cried for about half an hour with you two during your ceremony, just staring into each other's eyes, far too romantic. So, Alison, you look gorgeous. Paul, you look very handsome. And it's just been such a happy, happy day. Thank you.
I think the highlight is Phil not being able to say his thing at the wedding because he's blubbing so much.
So I'm going to describe Alison the way that I describe her to my clients, which is trying to get her across. And I always start by saying that she's really a hippie at heart. And but she doesn't wear Jesus sandals, and she actually likes to wear makeup and leather, really. So she's not exactly a hippie, but she's one of those people that is so beautiful. But what's more beautiful about her is actually what's inside as well as what's outside. And it's just so obvious to anybody who knows her that she's just sort of one of those sort of very special people. But she is a hippie when all said and done.
I think Ali Oggs is possibly the most lovely person I have ever met in my whole life. She's the sort of person that you could take anywhere and you'd feel comfortable her being there. I always like to say when I'm describing Oggs that she's got a slight hippie psychic tendency, but she doesn't dress like that. But she's my most gorgeous friend, and I love her very much.
I really find that I gel with Paul really well. He's very much like me. He's got this sort of mixed. He's a very, very bright bloke, but he's got this. He can express himself really well. He's very, very lyrical. But he's got this real sort of fiery edge to him, where, you know, he can be a lad's lad, but he's also got this. You know, he's got this very sort of friendly, sensitive side to him as well, which is good.
My response to peas and carrots are, they've got it absolutely correct. John and I are quite unique in quite a few ways, but I think all in all, nobody else would ever put up with each other. I think we're definitely meant to be together. And I think also that goes for Oggs and Paul.
And I just want to say a few things about Paul, really. I don't get the football, Paul. I don't know what it's all about. So if you've got a spare half an hour at some time, could you explain the offside rule to me? Because I can't get it. And really, I need to if I'm going to have to remain friends with you. Because obviously, you know, it's a great topic of conversation. And that you're just so lovely. And it's lovely to meet your parents, and you're just such a lovely man, and I think that you're very lucky to have such a lovely woman to marry as well.
This is a little message to Borough. You've got your World Cup MFL, and this will be the closest you get to lifting the World Cup, marrying Ali Oggs.
I really enjoyed coming to see you, Alison, before the wedding, just having those few minutes in the room with you while you were getting your makeup done, and you looked so excited and your eyes were really sparkly. And I remember I'd said to you that you look so lovely when your eyes look sparkly, and so I thought that was really good that your eyes were sparkling. I'm just thinking of something funny. Seeing Martin carrying the tray of oysters around was quite funny. I'm not quite sure how he managed to get a waiter's job. And just sitting in this room, I've just heard somebody say, I'd really like a tour, Auntie Irene. I can't do the Middlesbrough accent. That sounds a bit ridiculous, but it was funny. And I'm sure I'll be laughing a lot more later.
Well, I just want to say what a privilege it is to be here at Brian and Doreen's wedding. I know Brian and Doreen for a long time. Paul and Alison, what great ambassadors they are for love and affection. I must admit, the ceremony was a tribute to true matrimonial bliss. It was a delight to see so many tears cast by the congregation and also by the two exponents of the beautiful marriage ceremony. Borough, you're a top man, and Aliogs, all those green yin and yang and balancing your chakras has obviously made you a very loving person, and that comes through today. I must admit, so far the wedding's been top quality. The oysters seem to be working amongst some of the older generation. Some of the the ladies seem to have cast aside their HRT patches and are living on pure oyster and hoping for something special later. Borough's football control is something that I've admired for some time. The way he's managed to juggle his professional life and his love life is something I've admired for some time. I can't think of anything else to say apart from to say, well, I hope you both be very happy, and I'm sure you will. And when you see those footballers come out dressed in Middlesbrough tops with great footballing acumen and skill, but also knowing how to balance their yin and yang and keep the energy forces running through them, I think it'll be a delight to watch that day. Chin chin.
I think Borough looks absolutely gorgeous, and so does his father, and I'm finding him quite attractive.
Congratulations to you both. You've become really good friends of ours, and I'm sure you will be for the rest of your life.
Rushpool Hall is absolutely gorgeous. When we drove up to the gates, we didn't know if we got the right place. Drove in, nearly ran over two peacocks. Just drove down to the hall and just stood outside the car for about 2 minutes, just looking round and taking it all in. It's such a beautiful venue. It's absolutely perfect for you two, perfect for your wedding. And I'd love to come back here and stay again.
This is a personal message from myself to Paul and Alison on their special wedding day. I love you both very, very much indeed. You both mean the world to me. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life and future with you. I love you lots. Bye-bye.
Always stayed beneath my feet before. All at once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live. All the lilac trees in the heart of town. Can you hear a lark in any other part of town? does enchantment pour out of every door? No, it's just on the street where you live. And oh, the towering feeling just to know somehow you are near. The overpowering feeling that any second you may suddenly appear. People stop and stare, they don't bother me, for there's nowhere else on earth that I would rather be. Let the time go by, I won't care if I can be here on the street where you live. Can be here on the street where you live.
Hello, Alison. Hello, Paul. Well, I'd just like to say that, you know, I've been sewing since I was about 7, and I've sewed for all walks of life, here, there, and all over. And when you asked me to do your wedding dress, I was absolutely chuffed to bits. But when you showed me the wedding dress that you wanted me to copy, bearing in mind that, you know, I've been sewing so long, and I looked at it and I thought, shit. All these years, this is the first thing I've ever looked at and I thought, I haven't got the bloody foggiest idea how the hell this thing's constructed. And I went, yeah, Alison, I can do it. And as you know me, I like a challenge. And you were like, oh, great. And it has been a challenge, but can I just say, it has been the most enjoyable thing I've ever done, because I know you'd appreciate it. For all the wedding dresses I've done in the past, that has been by far the nicest thing, the nicest, and I've even hand-sewed things. I didn't even have to hand-sew. The other thing I'd like to say, I've also never been to a wedding where I knew that you two absolutely 100% deserved each other. And the other reason about the dress was, I know you'd keep it forever and you're never, ever, ever gonna need another one. So I'd just like to say, thank you for an absolutely lovely day, and thank you for an absolutely brilliant experience and creating something I've never done before. So I can't wait to put it on my CV, and I can't wait to see the pictures. And I just love Rushpool Hall. It's gorgeous, isn't it? So anyway, thanks.
I've had the most fabulous day, and my heart's been filled with love and happiness with Paul and Alison's like marriage, and it's just made me so happy. And what else can I say? It's been quality. I've been like having a fantastic time.
Excuse me, forgot my handbag. Thanks. Alison and Paul, I'm so, so privileged to be here for your wedding. I'm so happy. I'm just high and just, anyway. And I know you're really worried that basically once I got in this chair, I was never going to leave. But Chris has promised me I can come back between 2 and 6, like for the whole 4 hours. anyway, obviously, it goes without saying how beautiful you both are. And yeah, I hope I know you for the rest of my life, and I hope we're all together for the rest of our lives. So both of you, the fucking tops. Apart from Paul's hair at Sue's wedding.
Hello, I'm Beth. I'm just saying the wedding was really nice, and it was a really honour to be here, and I'm so glad it all went well. And it's a nice place to have it, and it was really nice here.
Just want to say congratulations to Alice and Paul. It's been such a magical, wonderful day. They're an excellent couple together. They're both really special people. The speeches were excellent, and I know around the tables near me, I had a lot of people reaching for the handkerchiefs and crying. It's a beautiful place to have the wedding. It's so nice to see everyone together, people that you don't know, meeting new people. It's just, I don't know how to explain it. It's just such a lovely day, and I hope you both have excellent lives together. I know you will, and that's about it, really.
And I know, Paul, you got your CD back, and you're very happy about that. Okay.
Alice and Paul, arrivederci, ciao. Have a really good time. Fantastic wedding. Top night, goodbye, and see you on Saturday.
I've got to say, I feel so honoured to be here. It is the first wedding I've been to, and it might be the last, where I just feel honoured, and they are a very special couple. Alison's a very magical, special person. Paul seems like a top bloke. I've never heard Alison criticise him, so they obviously have a fantastic friendship and communication. A lot of the people here are really lovely, and at the Green Gathering, the hen night was absolutely fantastic. And I'm quite overwhelmed, and I don't know what else to say.
Right. I'm up in a blab on for hours and hours and hours about what I feel and all that kind of thing. But I just want to say that I've had the absolute best time ever at the wedding. But it sounded like, you know, everyone's going to come in and go, oh, yeah, I said this. But I just had a brilliant time. And I really have. That's all I want to say, really, is what a good time I've had. And all the people I've met have been really, really nice. I mean, and that's all I want to say, really. Okay?
Hi, Alison and Paul. You know, I'm an excitable person, but the most exciting thing for me today was coming out of the bedroom and coming down a small set of stairs to the big set of stairs and just hearing everybody really excited, bubble of conversation, and me thinking, this is exactly how I thought it was going to be. And it's been fantastic. Thank you for inviting me.
Mr. and Mrs. Reaney, hello. Thank you so much for inviting me today. It's been the most beautiful, magical experience. I can't tell you how much I've enjoyed myself. It's been absolutely lovely. And I wish you all the very best in your life together. I'm sure it's going to be, well, it will be the most beautiful thing I can possibly imagine. And I can't really fault the day. It's just been wonderful. And yes, I will now ask for some questions from Big Brother.
Apart from the wonderful couple and who are getting married today, the venue and the whole setup, the views and the food have been absolutely spectacular, and the night has just begun. The speech and the marriage ceremony was so simple but meaningful and beautiful. Alison and her dress, and Ruth is here who made it. And the speeches from the best men were just, it was a very special and privileged friendship they've all got. And I feel very privileged to be here. And it's just starting, so hopefully we'll circulate and talk from here.
Right, my couple of special moments today about the wedding is, I see you coming down the stairs and I was blubbering. I bought extra tissues. I was giving them to all the girls from Stopover. I was literally handing them around. And I was crying when you came down the aisle, but I was okay from that. And as soon as we came outside, Paul's father was absolutely crying his eyes out, tears streaming down his face. And we offered him hankies, and I think it was his sister that was with him in the black and white hat. Anyway, he was absolutely beside himself. He couldn't believe how. And he kept saying, like, oh, but I'm normally really hard, but it's just, like, really emotional. Anyway, apart from your wedding list, I've got something really bad to tell you. I lost a list, and all I could think was, like, you've got, like, presents from Primark and Quality Seconds, like.
Right. I'd like to talk a little bit about the Big Green Gathering, because that was absolutely fantastic. And I have to say that I know Alison a little bit more than I know Paul, but knowing Alison, I know that her husband now, Mr. Reaney, is obviously going to be on a par with Mrs. Reaney, so they will be a beautiful couple together. I'd also like to say a little bit about the whole Rushpool Hall sort of like scenario, and I'd like to say that the whole chalet experience is fantastic. Peacocks, beautiful scenery, sunlight in the morning, what else can I say? Greenery, that's another word. I also like to say that I wish that I'd actually done my Big Brother thing before 9:30 at night, because I'm slightly tipsy and it would have been better a little bit earlier on, because I'm actually quite vocal, but not at this point in time. Anyway, I just think it's been a beautiful day, and the speeches were fantastic, and I don't often cry, but I have been crying a lot today. Because, oh no, it's starting to blood. Right, cut the cameras.
Alison, hello. What can I say? Obviously I blubbed at the wedding like a fool. I had probably a 20 second speech to say and messed that up, but I hope you don't mind, because obviously I was crying for the right reasons, and those reasons are is that two of the people who I love most dearly in the world were getting married, and it just all got so overwhelming to see you both there. After having known you for, like, you know, years and years, and being through what we've done, and Middlesex and Brighton and Bristol and blah, blah, blah. I mean, you know what I'm talking about. Just overwhelm me. So I hope you'll forgive me for that. I think you will, being the kind people that you are. The day's been so perfect. It's almost like I don't want to rationalise it because it's been so perfect, and I can't imagine it could have been any better. And I can honestly say it's one of the happiest days of my life. So I can't imagine what it must be like for you. I imagine, you know, it's well, I can't imagine. So I'm starting to ramble. So I'll just say I love you both, and I look forward to seeing all the people in there. This is an absolutely brilliant idea, and I'm a bit pissed. So forgive me if I got a bit emotional. And that's it. Love you both.
Dear Alison and Paul, I just want to say that I'm really happy that you invited us, and I feel really privileged to be here. I really enjoyed today when Paul had the speech and he was speaking Swedish, and that really touched me, and I just started crying. And I just feel like it feels like it's because of you two. You're so nice people, and me and David, we really like you, and we just wish that we could keep friends forever. So I've just had like the best wedding day in my life, so thank you very much for inviting us.
Hello, Paul and Alison. I am really pleased to be here, we both are, and really appreciate being invited here. We've had a lovely time. What stuck to my mind is how beautiful the wedding ceremony actually was. It made me cry. I'm not pleased to say, but it did. It's very touching. I've had a lovely time throughout the dinner, and it's just lovely to be here, basically.
I love Alison because she is totally non-judgmental, totally non-aggressive, and the first time I met her, she made me feel like I was the most special person in life.
I'm gonna cry again.
I've cried already today. I'll try not to cry again.
Hi, Paul, Alison. I'm quite drunk and I wanted to do this earlier on. And I was trying to do something funny and I can't think of anything funny now. And I love you both very, very much. And I hope to be with you in 25 years' time, celebrating this moment. And I'm doing lots of ums and lots of ands. I just love you both very much, and it's been one of the most lovely days of my life being with both of you today, and I'm so pleased that I could share it with you. I love you both.
I think that what has been really lovely about this day has been partly about meeting everybody that I've heard a lot about, and I'm sure Lester's heard or has met them anyway, kind of thing, but it's been partly to do with that, but also because I think that when you come to something like this and get reminded about people making vows to each other and saying so clearly how much they love each other, and it's not just how much they say, everybody can feel how much they love each other, then it also reminds you of how much you love the person that you've chosen to be with for your life, kind of thing. And that's, I suppose, has been something that I've taken from today. So thank you both very much. It's been a very, very special day and special weekend, because it's not stopping this evening. No. So thank you both very much.
Thanks for inviting us. Love you both.
I think you two are adorable people, Alison. I like you very much for your touching ways. I think you're a very, very good listener. And I think there's something that's underappreciated generally. I think it's one of the most beautiful talents that someone can have. And You know, I've appreciated that about you, Paul. You're a great lad.
Hey, up!
I appreciate the Borough t-shirt, I really do. I'll wear it with my mates. They'll probably kill me for it, but I will do. You know what for. What can I say? I've really enjoyed your company. You've been the friendliest people towards both of us. We're really, really happy to be here. And I think you're the most beautiful couple, and I think you'll really, really hit it off. Not as you had before, but you'll keep it on forever. Thanks.
I felt very touched today when Alison and Paul had been to the beach for their photographing, and Alison came back with a stone that looks like a heart. I just felt like it was very much like a sign, and it's just, oh, I don't know how to explain. it made the day more special, yes.
My dad says to me quite often, a wise man has something to say, and a fool says something. So I'm going to say something to you both. I'm never going to repeat it again. I love you both unconditionally. And I want you to be happier than I've been throughout my life, and as happy as you both possibly can be. I want you to know that I'll do anything for you, both of you, anything. And that's about it. I really do truly love both of you. Yeah, done. That's it. That's all I wanted to know.
The sun came out and the ceremony started, and they were so sincere with their words that it was just absolutely, absolutely gorgeous. And I know for a fact they'll be absolutely all right.
I'm in the room doing that Big Brother thing with the camera. Well, I don't know how long it's going to take me, sweetie, because I'm like a bit nervous. I can't help it. No, it's not rolling now. Huh? Hello? Well, I will. Well, I'll speak to you. I will. I'm going to have to start doing it because there's people queuing up as well. All right, then. I love you too. Bye. Oh, God. Do you mind if I swap and come back in a minute?
Yeah, that's all right.
I've got to get some thoughts and words in me.
Paul Nelson. God, what can I say? I'm really, really happy and honoured to be your best man today. It feels slightly weird because I know that I'm Paul's best man, but I've known Alison for, you know, the same amount of time that I've known Paul, so I kind of feel like I'm, you know, best man to you both. I hope I've done you proud, and I hope that, you know, you're as happy. I hope you're as proud of me as I am of you, and I hope that you'll both be very happy together. I know you will be very happy together. Memories of you two. God, so many that I was saying to the lads that the hardest thing about preparing the speech was all the stuff to leave out rather than the stuff to put in. So many happy memories. Jesus Christ, I've got so many funny stories about Paul which would not fit for polite human consumption in the speech, so I've had to leave them out. I mean, the obvious one for me is your first night out clubbing. I think you know what I mean. But you and I, we were at Middlesex at the time, and we got dinner jackets. We went to the Freshers Ball, which was the same night as Pushkar. And God, we left the Freshers Ball in our penguin outfits to go to Pushkar. Turned up at Pushkar, which is like quite a kind of trendy club night. And for the first 20 minutes, we were stood by the door waiting for people, and everybody thought that we were the doormen and kept asking us where the toilets were. And that was quite amusing. And then after that, the night just descended into complete and utter chaos, leading to me having to walk the whole club looking for you because you went on the missing list. I eventually spotted a pair of shiny shoes underneath a tree, and you were completely battered out of your head, sitting underneath this tree saying to me, "I'm gonna be okay, it's gonna be all right. Just leave me, just a minute, just give me a minute, just give me a minute." Which obviously to myself and Alison, who found you, was just absolutely hysterical. To see you so vulnerable, felt a bit weird, but I think when you got up and you started dancing, I think that's when you sort of came alive again then. But for that moment to see you so vulnerable and just hiding away and kind of almost in a fetal position underneath this tree was, it'll be an image that'll stick with me forever. Obviously not things that I could talk about in the speech, but I thought that saying it here would kind of be appropriate, maybe just for your consumption. Anyway, you both know by now how much you mean to me, and how honoured I am to be your friend. And as I say, hope you have a wicked life together, and have a great time in Tuscany. That's it.
Hi, Alison. Hi, Paul. Had an absolutely fantastic day. Everything was absolutely perfect. I mean, the first dance just made me swell up. I mean, it was gorgeous, and you're just such brilliant people. Just thank you for everything. I'll keep it short and sweet because I'm sure you've been Lind already, and just wish you all the happiest years together. Lots of love.
All right, Alison and Paul. Today's been absolutely fantastic, and it couldn't happen to better two people that I've ever known in my life. You're very good people. I trust you. I respect you. I hope your happiness always lasts forever in your hearts and in your souls and in your spirits. And I just hope you have an enjoyable life together. Thanks.
Hello, Alison and Paul.
Hello, Alison.
I thought today was beautiful, and for me, I really felt there was just a really special feeling at the service, which you don't get very often, but it just really felt like there was lots of love there. And I've got so many happy memories of us together. And I'm looking forward to lots more in the future.
Especially when the little kiddies come along, because you're going to know what it's going to be like, honestly. Believe you me. Yes, thank you, Paul. Thank you, Alison, for a wonderful day. We don't get to go out very much without the kids, and we don't get to be invited to many weddings, but this has been an absolutely wonderful occasion for us, and obviously for yourselves too.
And we wish you all the best for the future. You have a lovely future together.
And as for that dress, oh, lovely. If ever you want me to get rid of it on my stall, just let me know, please. I'll get you a good price for it. 50-50.
Okay.
Alison and Paul, can I just say, I drove all the way from Wales
and I'm so glad I did. Damn it, it's such a privilege to be here.
The bottom line is, Alison and Paul know what Bay is all about. Paul, you know what I'm about, and you've been there yourself, right? Bottom line is this, Paul. You're the geezer. Deliver. Always be the top man. Always go for it, like myself. You know the score, man. No big deal. You're the man, like myself. Go there.
Paul and Alison, best of bridges to you on your fine day. This is quite emotional for the three of us, but we just thought perhaps we'd like to say, express our thanks and best wishes for the day.
Thank you.
In a song that hopefully you can sing along to at home.
It goes down something like this.
One, two, three.
My one skin lies over my two skin. My two skin lies over my three. My three skin lies over my...
I'd just like to say that this is going to go down in my history, my life history, as one of the best days of my life. Alison is probably one of the most special people that I've ever met and I'm ever likely to meet. I've known her since I was 14, so we've known each other for 18 years and we've never had an argument apart from once about a bit of sweet corn on a plate. I absolutely love Paul to bits. I think she's definitely found her life partner there. And me and Paul both know we've got a very special relationship of our own. It's 10 o'clock at night and Alison, this is about the 50th time I've done this. And also, just like to show you these. Can you see those? Watch the... Can you not see them? I'd just like to show you these from Kim. I'm sure I'm going to get another 8 of them by the end of the evening. Stop. Okay. Well, I've absolutely got to do this, first of all. Because I feel really nervous and I knew I'd do it. So I don't know what to say. It wouldn't be me if I didn't do it. But it's late at night and I'm pregnant and I'm feeling very tired. So I'm probably a bit delirious. But I'd like to say that I've had an absolutely fantastic day. I feel very happy and I feel very proud that I'm Paul and Alison's friend. I just love Alison like a sister. Julie and I have always said she's our adopted sister because we love her so much. And I just loved it when she said her speech and she mentioned Julie, and I felt very emotional and very tearful and just thought it was beautiful. The whole day has been brilliant. Feels really special. You're gonna have to stop it because I don't know what to say.
I'd like to start by saying what I like about Paul. What I like about Paul is his eternal optimism about Middlesbrough. Also, his never-say-die attitude. Quite often, when we're playing squash together, he's getting hammered, but he always comes back and beats me. I don't like that. He also doesn't like getting nutmegged at football, which I do quite often. When Alison and Paul have children, he'll be a competitive dad. It'll be full-facing bat when you're hitting through the covers, Justin. You'll never reach my total of 732 not out like that. But I do like Paul.
Alison is a very, very special person. She's completely unique. She's just the best friend anybody could wish for. She's always there for you, no matter what the situation. You know, if you're troubled, whatever, she's always there and very supportive and always has very good advice to give. And she's a great laugh. She's always happy and always sees a positive side to things. And she's absolutely beautiful. And she's game for a laugh. She's up for anything. She's just absolutely great to be around. And whenever I'm around her, I just feel instantly happy and calm and just great and thrilled to be a friend. Alison, apart from when that Weller rep made me give you that dodgy perm just before you were going to Lorette for your holidays, I've had an absolute nightmare with your hair, as you know, but I did think that your hair looked absolutely stunning today. I enjoyed every minute of doing it and it was brilliant to be part of getting you ready for your special day. I've really enjoyed it. I haven't felt stressed out at all. I've enjoyed the whole day so much. I've loved being on the top table. I can't believe that was ever an issue. It made him feel very special, and the speech that you gave at the end made the hard work that put into the Green Gathering worth every single minute and shoulder killing worthwhile.
Before the wedding, I had to ask Paul and Alison if they'd put together a list for me of all the people who were coming today, because I needed to know which ones they most wanted to get into the diary room, because obviously I don't know all of Paul and Alison's friends and relatives, and which ones are the most important to them. So Paul has put together this really nice Excel spreadsheet for me, which has got a red section at the top, which means you must get all of these people into the diary room at all costs. And then underneath that, there's the orange section, which means we'd really like you to get these people into the diary room if you've got time. And then underneath that, there's the yellow section, which means, well, we'd really like you to get these people in if you've got time, but if you don't worry too much about it. Well, the funny thing is, I think the word of this list has got around today because a couple of people have said to me, oh, Chris, is that the list? Can I have a look at it? And you know why, because they want to see how far up the list they are, but don't worry, I'm keeping it absolutely confidential.
When I first met Alison, I was very, very pleased because my sister, Julie, was hanging around with some very dodgy girls, which I didn't like at all, right borough-lasses, and I saw Alison, and my first impression was, oh, what a fantastic dress sense. She had a beautiful knitted suit on, and she had one in every colour. She had a suit in peach, purple, green, and pink, and they were all the same, they all matched, and she had a beautiful brown leather edge-to-edge jacket that topped it off nicely, and I thought, that's the sort of girl Julie wants to be hanging around with, so I was very, very pleased. We haven't looked back since.
It's been a fantastic day. I didn't know quite what to expect. You envisage something that's going to happen, and in your mind's eye there's always something there, and to me what I envisaged did actually happen, and I actually thought it was fantastic, and it was a fantastic day. It was lovely to be part of it. To me, with sort of Alison and Paul, I don't know them that well. It's a sort of start of a friendship, I think. It's been maybe sort of 2 years that I've known them. I mean, with me and Catherine having a baby and a house, obviously that's, and them getting married and hopefully staying in Brighton, it's the start of a long relationship, which I think is just starting, and I hope sort of as time goes on it will get stronger and stronger. I mean, I don't think at all I'm one of the sort of leading parties as far as Paul and Alison goes at the moment, but I'm hoping that later on that will sort of naturally be so. But yeah, it was fantastic, and I do feel absolutely honoured to be here, and I'm just very happy, completely.
Alison and Paul, I've known you for a lot of years. Alison most more than Paul, but I think you're absolutely wonderful, a wonderful couple. And I just have had a fabulous day. It's absolutely been wonderful. And my emotions are just so, over the top. I just don't know what to say to you, but thank you so much for a wonderful day. And I wish you every happiness in life. And it's just so wonderful being part of your friends, and you're like more like family to me than, you know, anybody else. You're the nearest to family that I could get, and Alison, you know that. And I just wish you every happiness in the world. And what more can I say? Just love to you both, and God bless for the future.
Alison and Paul, thank you very much for inviting me to your very special day, and I've had a lovely time. It is, though, the first time I've been invited somewhere and been told I can only come if I bring my cards. However, they do seem to have come in useful, and I've really enjoyed it very much. Thank you, and best wishes to both of you.
What I like about Alison, she always has this ability to listen and also ask questions. I do think that she has an almost magical presence. I think she has an elfin pixie quality. I think there's something about her, especially when she's in Cornwall, land of the fairies. The time in Newquay when she just disappeared across Newquay Harbour. The time we were in Middlesbrough and she led me over the magic bridge to a darker side. Her love of the tarot. Her association with the family Oberon, King of the Fairies. But maybe I've been led up the garden path just like the fairies. Who knows? But all I'd like to say is I love them both and I wish them every happiness in the future.
I loved an absolutely lovely day. I thought Paul and Alison looked absolutely stunning. I love Alison to bits because what I like about her, she's always very positive about everything, and she makes me feel that whenever I've seen her, if I'm a bit down, she always cheers me up. And Paul is very happy-go-lucky, and I think they're a lovely couple, and I wish you all the very best, and I'm absolutely shattered now, my feet are killing me, so I'd like to go to bed.
Also, Alison, before Paul moved into Brewer Street, I'd never actually seen you get angry with anybody. Some of your arguments were unbelievable about kitchen cupboards. I can't believe I'd forgotten about it, because what I should have bought you for your wedding present were storage drawers from IKEA. It would have made your married life absolutely harmonious. You'd have nothing else to fall out over.
I've just sort of completed what I was going to say, Chris has said, is it fine? I thought it probably is okay, but I've sat here sat somewhere, thinking, what shall I say, what shall I say? And I don't really know what is a good thing to say, whether you should be honest, maudling, whatever. I think Alison would definitely sort of think honesty is the way to go. I think she would, God, I'm suddenly going to become quite insightful. I think Alison would definitely like honesty, sitting here, this is what she thinks. Paul, I think, you know, if you can say something witty, which I obviously can't think of anything witty at all now, but it's funny that I think 80% of people that sat outside or 2 weeks previous thinking what they wanted to say when they actually do come in here is completely different. And I don't think I'm any exception. I think that's it.
I'd just like to wish you both a wonderful, beautiful, happy life together. And I just know it's going to work, and I don't really need to say that because I know it will be. And I just love you both very much and just hope that you're always in my life. That's it.
Oh, and one last thing, just to round it up. I don't feel like I've lost a sister today. I've actually gained another brother.
That's it.
Maybe trouble ahead, but while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance. Before the fiddlers have fled, before they ask us to pay the bill, and while we still have the chance, let's face the music and dance. Soon we'll be without the moon, humming a different tune. And then there may be teardrops to shed. So while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance. Let's face the music and dance. Without the moon, humming a different tune. And then there may be trouble ahead, but while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance. Before the fiddlers have fled, before they ask us to pay the bill, and while we still have the chance, let's face the music and dance. Soon we'll be without the moon, humming a different tune. And then there may be teardrops to shed. So while there's moonlight and music and love and romance, let's face the music and dance. Let's face the music and dance. Congratulate
Paul and Alison on a wonderful, wonderful wedding. In fact, I would say it's one of the best weddings I've ever been to. There's been lots of love and attention all around from the guests, and especially Paul and Alison. They obviously look delighted with each other, and they're going to stay in each other's arms for a very, very long time. The friends that they have wonderful, and some of the things they've said in their speeches was absolutely great.
Hello, Alison and Paul. It's Norma here. Just to say what a wonderful day I've had. It's been the most marvellous experience. We've all enjoyed meeting all your friends and listening to the great affection you have for each other. And I want to wish you both a very, very, very happy honeymoon and happiness for the rest of your life. Love to both of you.
Carl made some wonderful speeches after getting up from the table about his other three mates and Alison as well when they were at college together and when they separated for a short while together. And they were that very, very closely involved. I've never in my life had friends as good as that. I've got some good friends, but never had any like that. That's about it, I think. I think I've said enough.
Hello, Alison and Paul. Hasn't it been an absolutely wonderful day? And the sun came out when you were making your wedding vows. And it was marvellous to meet all the friends that you've told me about. And as you mentioned, Alison, it was marvellous to see them all in the same room together, celebrating you and you and Paul on your wedding day. And I'm sure this video that Chris is making for you will be a marvellous, marvellous thing for the to keep for the rest of your lives, recording this absolutely wonderful, wonderful day. And I hope you have an absolutely marvellous honeymoon. Love to you both, ma'am.
It's been a lovely day, Alison and Paul. I've really enjoyed it. It's been very emotional. I don't know what else to say. It's the best wedding I've ever been to, and you look absolutely fabulous. And I hope you have really happy years together. Karen.
I'd just like to say this is my most memorable day in my life, with Alison to Paul's wedding. I'm a bit lost for words, but it was very, very emotional to me. I love my daughter dearly, and I know that she's got a perfect partner in Paul. The speeches were absolutely magnificent. I don't know about mine, but I think it well, so I've been told, in different places, toilets and bars, It went down very well. The emotional thing to me was the way Alison reciprocated to Paul at the anniversary in the theatre, as I may say, or the church, whatever, was so emotional to me, and the majority of people were all in tears. I had a lump in my throat, but I didn't cry. And all I want to do now is say to Paul and Alison, the best of luck in your lives together. And I will do anything in my life to make it so. I think that's all I've got to say. But I will do any mortal thing for them, because I love them both dearly.
I think Paul's a brilliant lad. He'd adapt to anybody, get along with anybody, quite very honest, and he'd tell you what he thought. And she couldn't have met a nicer lad than Paul. He'd be very supportive with Alison the rest of her life.
And thank you for giving me the opportunity to read the reading I read to you both. I know you both love that poem, and I loved it too. And when I read it to you both, I meant it with all my heart.
This wedding's been different for me because it's been grander than I could have experienced. I don't really know what to say. I feel I still feel a little bit churned up. I feel proud that I've got a wonderful son. It's one of my few achievements that I've achieved through my life is having Paul, and the fact that he chose Alison and Alison chose him to be together. I know that actually you love each other. You can see that with everything you do and the way you speak to each other. And I've watched you all day today with pride. Both of you, not just Paul, and Alison as well. And, you know, and I want to stick my chest out and say, you know, this is my son, but this is also his beautiful bride. And also another daughter, which, Alison, you know that I've always thought of you as that for a lot of years. And I'm a bit stuck.
The experience for me today as a parent is that I want my son to have a happy married life. And this morning at home, it was relaxed, really. And I thought it might not be. I thought it might have been frenetic, moving around, trying to get ready together, but it panned out really, really nice. And although I was worried about the speech-making side of things, we helped each other along with that. And the main point for me today was the power of the feeling in the ceremony. And I'm a roughy toughy from the borough, but it got to me a little bit. I never thought I would cry at my son's wedding, but there I was crying at the ceremony. And for me, you could have made a film from the ceremony. It was so, so good. It was such a love story type encounter. And the feeling and the power generated from two people coming together. I don't think I ever gonna have to worry about Paul and Alison coming together and being one person. And rowing across that lake together, trying to solve the problems and get that out of the shore. I just feel it's going to be good. And because my own experiences of marriage has been so good, I want Paul to have the same feeling. And for me, the day revolves around the feeling, but also a lot of effort and energy has been put into the day by lots of people from all different angles. The cake, the band, speeches. And my own speech, I was worried to death about, and I'd rather have gone to the dentist's. But surprisingly, it went quite well. And people said I should speak from the heart, and that's just what I tried to do. And it's been such a nice day, such a nice location, so many nice people. I've thoroughly enjoyed it. And I'm going to drink some more and enjoy it even more. So, for me, it couldn't be better. And I've enjoyed it.
When Paul and Alison got engaged, it was a Christmas day. We were all excited in our house because we all knew what Paul was going to do. And he was going to meet Alison down in the avenue of trees. And when they arrive back, and I'm trying to look to see if she's got the ring on the finger, and the telephone's ringing because different ones in our family knew that Paul was going to propose this day. Alison knew nothing about it, and I'm trying to look on her finger to see if the ring's there, you know, knowing it. And of course, because we knew, I had a bottle of champagne ready and a card ready to give them, and you know, and see, it was a nice day because it was the first time as well that Paul's Auntie Kathleen and her husband had come home for 35 years and had Christmas with us. So it was extra special in that way that his godparents were there and he didn't even know they were coming, which was, that was nice.
Hello. I just want to tell you that I feel so emotionally charged. I so love you so much. Oh, I didn't think I was going to cry, but I feel a bit emotional now. I'm so happy that you're together and it's all worked out great. And obviously me and Paul have been together a long time. And it's just fantastic that
you've kind of took over my mantle, Alison, and it's just... Oh, I couldn't wish for anybody better for Paul to be with, and it's fantastic that you get on with Steve so brilliantly. And the four of us can have such a close, loving relationship. I never want to think that me and Paul will never be together, that we won't communicate. Even in the years and years from now when our parents have gone and we're still just brother and sister, I want us to really keep in contact. Wherever we are, and whatever we do, I just really feel like it should always be there, me and you. And the four of us together, I think it's just fantastic. I'm so happy and it's just brilliant. I'm so proper chuffed for you both and it's just amazing. I'm really privileged to be your sister and I wish sometimes I could be more for you, but I'm not. But that's okay as well. It's wicked, mate. I'm proper chuffed for you both and thanks very much for just letting me be a part of everything that you do. That's it. It's done.
I was kind of thrown into this family, the whole Reaney family, from being Nicola's boyfriend, who's Paul's sister. And I came to this wedding as an outside guest, more than anything, even though I've got to know Paul and Alison. Obviously, I wasn't as close as some of the people here, but I can't believe how emotional I've been. There was a... And the point that it started was seeing Irene, Paul's mum. I could see that she'd clocked Alison walking down the aisle, and I could see her eyes well. And at that point, I knew that it was going to be an emotionally charged night. Even though I haven't known very long, I love them both. They're great people. And I think they've become my friends rather than just my girlfriend's family. Irene, Derek, Paul and Alison, and I'm sure they'll have a great life together, and that is about all I'd like to say. Cheers.
Am I in the right position?
Yeah. Okay.
Alison, what a perfect end to a perfect day. I've caught your book. It's absolutely amazing. I can't believe it. Love you both.
The whole day we've been, well, I think I've been waiting for the bouquet to be thrown. I mean, it happened right at the end, and it was just, I think Julia's in previous to me and got the majority of the bouquet, but quite funnily, 20% of it flew straight at Catherine. So, Catherine's mum and dad, especially Catherine's mum, was absolutely ecstatic. That just means one of them has to be married within the next year, definitely. And I think I was actually quite excited that Catherine actually got some of the bouquet. So maybe I will have to do something about it and hire Chris again for our wedding. I don't know. But anyway, it was I liked it, so I think that must mean something.
Alison, I know you've asked me to do it a couple of times if I'm enjoying myself, because I know that you think that basically I've just been completely stressed out today, rushing around, being rushed off my feet, and I haven't been able to enjoy myself, but I have enjoyed every minute of today. I'm going to be spending the next year finding out how to edit video together, because I haven't got a clue how to do it.
Things have changed. It got really funky down there, and I was just getting lost in the music. Then it went really cheesy. Then it went really funky. Then I ran out of dancing partners. Then you didn't have Candy Stat and You Got the Love. And then Manish showed me the Buffy room. And I'm telling you something, apart from the sit-down room, the Thai fish cakes for the dog's bollocks. This. It's fucking tasty. I'm telling you, this is a tasty wedding. I'm telling you straight. This is the tastiest wedding I've ever been to. And when this is finished,
It's only just starting because they haven't hit the rooms yet. To see what's happened after hours. I'm going to save one of these and I'm going to meet my man tonight. I'm going to tempt him because he doesn't know what he's bloody missing. I'm telling you now. Smashing. Completely bloody smashing. Nice one.
Hi, Ali. Hi, Paul. I just want to say what a fantastic day and evening this has been. It's just been absolutely wonderful being part of it, and it's just been really special. And just to see you two together today and how much you love each other, it's just been amazing. I can't quite describe really how I felt being here, but it's been lovely as well. And meeting sort of all friends that I've heard you talk about who I haven't actually had the pleasure or chance to meet before, that's been fantastic. And thank you so much, Ali, for all the trouble you made as well, so that I got a special dish which went down very well at the dinner table tonight. And just like to say how much I appreciate obviously both your friendships, but particularly Ali's. I just wish you all the best for your life together, really, and I know that you will be incredibly happy together, and look forward to being sort of part of sharing and continuing being friends with you both.
And we're going to go for a walk now and see what else is happening around it, because if we're on campus, there's people in these flash rooms and it's all going on. But we just need to know whereabouts. We're going to go and knock on a few doors. Thank you very much, and we'll tell you more later. Ta-da.
And also, can I just say, Chris Overton is like being bloody diamond, because all he's done all day and night is have a fucking camera, excuse me, is have a video camera in front of him, and I think to Chris.
Hello, Alison, and hello, Paul, and thank you for inviting me to your lovely wedding day. And I've heard lots of wonderful things about your speeches, and I've spoken to Alison's mum, and I've seen some wonderful people, and I can tell that there's a lot of love here, and so many people think the world of both of you, and you're a match made in heaven, and I wish you all the best. And that's it, really, and you're in my thoughts, and you will be for a long time, probably forever. So have a wonderful life together, and that's it, really. I think I'm the last one, and it's 2:30 in the morning. So night-night.
Thank you.
Let there be cuckoos, a lark and a dove. But first of all, please let there be love. Love, love, let there be love.
I've often walked down the street before, but the pavement always stands in the feet before. All at once I am several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live.
Morning. I just felt, well, I didn't sleep very well last night. I was really tossing and turning. I got to sleep at about 4 o'clock and I was quite concerned that I just was thinking, oh, I'm not going to be able to enjoy it. I'm going to be really tired. I woke up this morning, I had my breakfast brought to my bedroom, my little four-poster bed, and I boiled eggs and toast, and I sat in my bed and I wrote my speech. I was just trying to sort of really savour the moment of this is my wedding day. And then I went into the room next door, into the oak room, and Judy came and Louise came and started getting ready. I had a lovely bath, I drank champagne in the bath. I'd really relaxed and took some really deep breaths because I was thinking I'm not going to be able to hold it together. I just felt so overwhelmed with the whole thing. And Julie and Louise and Jenny just were all around me, and Kim, and my mum and Karen had come in and had a chat, and it was just so breathtakingly lovely. And it got to about an hour before the photographer came, And Ruth came and she put on my dress. And I was getting really nervous thinking, it's going to be an hour before I'm getting married. This is actually, I was really nervous. I wanted to turn the clock back and have some more time. Not because I didn't want to marry Paul, but just because I thought, I'm not going to be able to compose myself. It was just so overwhelming. And then the time came, the registrar came in, and then they called me, they phoned me in the room and called me to come downstairs that were ready for me. I had to take some really deep breaths. And I walked down the stairs and Karen was behind me holding my train of my dress. And I walked down the stairs and I was really, really shaking. I was really, really, really nervous. Just about the whole sort of emotion of the occasion, it was almost like the nerves were just part of it. Now when I look back, the nerves were part of it, but I just couldn't believe how incredibly nervous I felt. And just sort of so shaky. I really thought my legs were gonna actually give way beneath me. I turned around and before I went into the room and Nicola and Julie and my sister, Karen, were there and I said, look, you need to make me laugh. I need to feel light about this. Because not taking it lightly, but I just had to compose myself and feel quite grounded with it. The registrar said, walk as slowly as you possibly can, just take it all in. And I walked into the room with my mum and my dad, one on either side, which was just lovely. That just sort of meant so much to me. And walked down the aisle and I looked at all the faces and everybody was just really smiling and I just sort of felt a lot of warmth from everybody. And I could see Paul looking at me and I walked down the aisle and I got to the bottom of the aisle and I said to Paul, you all right? And he said, now that you're here, I am. And that was just absolutely lovely. And I thought I need to hold his hand, so I held his hand just so I could feel sort of connected and that would make me feel a lot more sort of grounded, because that was what I was doing. At the end of the day, that's what I'm doing here. I was marrying Paul, so I held his hand and the ceremony was just breathtaking. The sun came out, I was looking out to the window and I could see the sea and that just that gorgeous view and it was just incredible. Then my mum did her reading and she was really emotional. My mum isn't somebody who really cries a lot, she's a very strong person. And she was really emotional and that in some ways made me feel better because I felt like, I said to Sue, why did that feel all right? When my mum was emotional, I sort of felt okay. And she said, because if your mum, it's all right to be emotional. If your mum's being emotional, then, you think it's all right. And that really sort of calmed me. And it was just so lovely what she was saying. But it actually sent Paul a bit over the edge and he was fighting back tears when my mum was speaking. And then Sarah came up, lovely Sarah, I've known her since I was 5 years old, and she said the poem which Paul wrote for me 5 years ago when we were going through quite a difficult time, and it was just a real sort of, like he was reaching out saying, I want to be with you, and she read that poem, which was just incredible, an incredible experience. And that then sent, I heard Paul saying, I wrote this poem to Phil, so that sent Phil over the edge. And there was just so much love around. It was absolutely incredible. I've never, ever experienced so much sort of warmth and love. It was just so sort of surreal and special. And I just thought it's for us, it's just that for our relationship. And Phil then he was doing the third reading. He had to get Carl to do the reading because he was so emotional. But the funny thing about it was, is that there were, Carl was saying to Paul, watch him. Like when Gaza was in the World Cup and he was crying, they went like that, watch him. That's what they were doing about Phil because he was just couldn't cope and he was actually in pieces, which I absolutely loved him for it. I just thought how lovely the fact that, I just love Phil so much and he was just sort of like sent over the edge. And that, and in some ways, like, was even nicer than him doing the reading, and Carl did the reading for him, but it was almost like Phil speaking through Carl, which was just incredible. And I could hear in the background just the two of us, Bad Will Withers, playing, and Paul and I really wanted that to be played. and we signed the register, and Julie came over, and Phil, who were our witnesses, and we signed the register, and it was just really overwhelming. Then we walked back up the aisle and everyone was blowing bubbles, and it was just, I mean, that's what I wanted. It's just sort of walking through this sea of bubbles, which was just incredible. And then we went to the top of the aisle, and it was just amazing. We just both felt so happy. Like, when Paul was saying his vows, he was just looking at me so intently, and it just felt like he really wanted to sort of express every single sentiment of all the words that he was speaking. And I felt the same. By that time, I felt really composed, and I just really wanted to sort of, you know, return that to him and say every single word was just really sort of very heartfelt and meaningful. And the other special moment then of the photography was when we went down to Saltburn Seafront, and it was just absolutely amazing. Just walking through the sand and looking, hearing the sea and walking down on the beach, and it was just absolutely incredible. And everybody has just been saying, I mean, Kim, bless her, you know, she said to us, everyone is just having such a lovely time because you just, like, radiate love. I mean, what a lovely thing to say. That was just absolutely gorgeous. The speeches were just incredible. Everything that everybody said just had so much sort of meaning, and everybody just really wanted to speak and say those words. There was nothing about performance. It was just very sort of heartfelt, but also very funny, and I really, really enjoyed that. And it's been a bit of a whirlwind in a sense. When we had our first dance, you know, we'd been to dancing classes, and I know that this has been on video, and I was worried. I was thinking, we're not going to be able to do it. Paul was really confident and really getting into it. And then when we actually got on the dance floor, he went, I'm not sure I can remember. And I went, look, Paul, it's absolutely fine. Let's just enjoy it. We know that nobody's actually seen this. We're absolutely fine. Just enjoy it. And I could see everybody around us. And I was just thinking, right, no, we're going to be all right. We're going to be all right. We're saying, just do it. It'll be absolutely fine. If we actually start going wrong, just do the thing, just together, just the little sort of shimmy thing, and it'll be fine. And we did it, and I absolutely loved it, and it went really well. And then Paul's now saying to the band, oh yeah, we'll do it again later, we'll definitely do it again, because he was just like, oh yeah, great, get loads of sort of like credit for it, and then we'll just do it again so we get more. So obviously Nee now just doesn't want to get off the dance floor. And then it was lovely because afterwards they then played I've Often Walked Down the Street Before, which is one of Paul and I's favourite songs, and everyone got on the dance floor and started doing sort of that 50s sort of dance, which I love. I find really romantic, because I think the sad thing is about dancing now is you don't dance together. And that was just sort of amazing, just sort of that everybody, I was looking around and seeing all the people that I love, all the couples together doing all the dancing. They were all just really in love and hugging each other, and that was really, really, really special to me, just looking around and seeing everyone having a wonderful time at Paul and I's wedding. And that has been what something about the day which I've absolutely loved, the fact that everybody has just been so amazing. Like my mum said, Alison, everyone is just, there's so many lovely people here, it is just incredible, the atmosphere is incredible, and I just really appreciate that and really value it, and I will never forget this day as long as I live. I'm done.
Right, when I woke up this morning, I sort of forgot that I was getting married. And for the first couple of hours, I played Keep It Weezy in the back garden with my dad and Phil. We had a bit of guitar, me, my dad, Phil, Solly and Lee, we were talking to Solly and Lee as well, and a bit of breakfast as well. To be honest with you, I forgot that I was getting married. And the reality hit me when Steve and Carl walked in their suits with their, you know, I mean, with the suits that we'd agreed to buy. And all of a sudden, I'm getting married.
I'm getting married in a couple of hours. Unbelievable. And then when that's when my adrenaline really started flowing. I went and got ready. And to be honest with you, what I found is when I'm getting married, I was trying to capture episodes of private time whenever I could. I was trying to, when I was in the shower, for example, I was on my own. I was trying to have a little bit of private time, just taking everything in. You know, my friends and family have come from all over the country. I'm having a shower, washing myself, getting ready for the day. Left there, got in the car with the ribbons on. Obviously the people that are around me as well have got like a much greater sort of actualisation of the day than I have. Because I'm sort of, I've got so much that I've got to try and take in at the same time. It's impossible. So I'm a mess, you know. And other people, because they've only got their certain realities to relate to, they're sort of focused on what they're doing, and they're calm with it, you know. But I didn't know what to do. To be fair, anyway, got in the car from Middlesbrough to Saltburn. Got to Saltburn. I had 2.5 pints in the ship, and I could temper the amount that I drank perfectly. I could feel exactly where I wanted to be with the amount of alcohol that I drank. It's like a surreal experience in itself. I had 2.5 pints in the ship. Once I got 2.5 pints, I thought, this is where I want to be as far as my intoxication is concerned. It's taken the nerves off, but I'm still in a position to enjoy what I'm about to undertake. Got the car from the ship to Rushpool Hall. Went to Rushpool Hall, saw a few faces. Started talking to a few people I hadn't seen for a while. One thing led to another, and before I knew it, I was stood at the front of the aisle, and I'm stood there, and I'm absolutely calm as you like. I'm confident, I'm relaxed, I'm really enjoying the day. And then with about 2 or 3 minutes to go, I thought, I'm getting married. I'm getting married, like. And then the nerves really started to kick in. And before, and I swear to God, the whole morning before then, I'm being absolutely fine. And with 2 or 3 minutes to go, I thought, Christ, you know, the nerves. I thought, all these people have turned up to experience this day, and I'm the focal point of their attention. Me and Alison and I are the focal point of their attention. But by virtue of the fact that Alison wasn't there, I'm the focal point. And then I said to the registrar, you know, when can I turn around and look at my bride? And she said, I'll tell you when. So I'm stood in Rushpool Hall. There's like everyone that I know and love, and all the people that I love behind me, and they're really excited. And I'm stood there, and I'm trying to, like, it's almost like a masquerade of confidence, because I want everyone else to be relaxed, so I have to be relaxed too. And she said, no. I turned around and I looked at Alison, and it was magical. I looked at the woman that I was going to marry. I looked at my bride, and she was beautiful. She was beautiful. She wasn't just beautiful in a physical sense. She was beautiful. She was beautiful in the sense of reassurance. And part of beauty is reassurance. Part of beauty is familiarity. And when I turned around and saw that familiarity, God, it made me feel fantastic. I had all the excitement without any of the trepidation. That part of excitement is nervousness. And I had all that excitement without any nervousness. And the reason for my lack of nervousness was my partner. And then she walked down the aisle. And to be honest with you, I've obviously thought at length what I was gonna say to my partner when she walked down the aisle. And I thought, I wanted to like hold her and said, you look beautiful, or you know all these like really gorgeous things, and all these like, you know, all these really articulate things that I wanted to say. And the word I said was hello, and she said hello to me, and it was like, it was perfect, you know. It was not, you know, they're the words that you use, like hello. Then we held each other's hand, and the ceremony started, and I could feel that my hand was red hot and her hand was red hot too. We were both really nervous, but we were nervous for the right reasons, you know, wanted everything to go well. And he went through the ceremony, and then obviously I looked into her eyes, and I tell you what, I'll never forget when I looked into her eyes. God, it was like never looking into anyone's eyes in my experience of my life. It was like, I don't want to be sort of like overbearing, but I did look into her soul, you know, I did look into another person's soul, and I held her hands, and I said the things that I wanted to say. It was great. It was great. And then the ceremony went by, and obviously Phil cried. That was great too. And you know, the readers were great. And I could feel there was an energy in the room. There was a familiarity in the room. There was a union in the room, to be fair. There was like 100 people, and we all wanted the same thing. And I think everyone shared in the experience, to be honest with you. And then when we left the wedding ceremony, we went into the car. We had a few photographs, sort of thing. And the first time that I was able to take a breath is when Alice and I were sat in the car to go with the photographer, to go and have our photographs on the beach. And we were sat in the back of the Audi. And we held each other's hands, and it, like, that very public sentiment that we had was, I can't think of the word, but it was like, it was concentrated into a moment where Alice and I were holding hands and we were together. It was brilliant, absolutely brilliant. We had our photographs taken on the beach, and we came back. And obviously, we're man and wife now. It's what everyone wanted us to be, and fantastic. Had a few drinks, had oysters, and then we mulled around for a while. And then we went into the speeches. The speeches, fantastic. Again, you know, it's almost like a perfect day. Ken made his speech, and when Ken was making his speech, obviously my adrenaline started pumping because I knew I was next. But I was pretty confident about my speech, to be fair, because while I hadn't prepared as much as I would like, I knew that I knew I could ad lib and probably get through it. But when I started making my speech for the first 30 seconds, I was really, really nervous. And after a while, after 30 seconds, I started really enjoying it. I started loving the prospect of having 5 minutes of the time of all these people that I share my life with, and saying something really important to them, about saying things like what they meant to me, you know, how much I love my new wife, and that was great. That was great. And get, you know, and obviously there was a bit of pressure on me to make them laugh, and I think I made them laugh a little bit, and hopefully made them cry, you know, made them, you know, understand the strength of feeling that I had for the woman I was going to get married to. And then Carl and Steve made their speech, and theirs was fantastic. That was brilliant. I didn't mind getting ridiculed for 20 minutes. That was brilliant. I just wish they'd said something a little bit nicer about me, but they didn't. Well, that was fine. But then my dad stood up to make a speech, and people have been very complimentary about my family. That's really important, you know. It's because I understand how nice my family are. Nice doesn't really do them justice, but I understand how loving and supportive and nurturing and magical they are. And for other people to see that, other people that I hold dear, that's wonderful. So my dad made a speech, and everyone laughed, obviously. And after that, you know, I felt like I could relax. I felt as though I got into a position where I could really relax. And I was having a wonderful day with Alison as well, you know. It was like we were both enjoying it on the same level. That was fantastic, you know, it was fantastic. And then we had a drink in the bar, walking around, talking to everyone. And throughout the whole experience, I felt a sense of goodwill. And people warned me about this. They said that when they'd been married, you'd be overwhelmed with a sense of goodwill. And I wasn't prepared for it, to be honest with you. Mentally, I had prepared myself for the compliments and the sense of that everyone wanted us to do well and congratulations, etc. But I didn't realise like how much of my call it would affect. I thought that everyone's sense of good, I thought I would be removed from the sense of goodwill and that I would be able to deal with it and say, and smile and say thank you very much and it's very nice, and I thought I would be able, like, I thought that, like, the critical, cynical side of me would be able to remove himself from the experience, but I couldn't. It touched me. It really did. It touched me to my core, to be honest with you. Every person to a man or woman said how much they had a wonderful day and how much they loved Alison and I, and they really did mean it. They did, you know. I can't remember a person who spoke to me and was positive about the wedding experience. I can't remember a person who I thought, yeah, they're just saying it because they've got to. They didn't. They meant it. And then Alison and I did our wedding dance, and that went perfectly. That was wonderful. That was great. It went as well and better than I could have expected. And now I'm in a position where I just want to relax. I just want to talk to people. I've got one more thing to say. Tonight, I did something that for 32 years I've wanted to do. And for a man who's lived and grown up in Middlesbrough, for me to tell my dad that I loved him, that was a moment in my life. That was probably, in some ways, the most special moment of my life. And when I said I loved him, and I said he was my hero, and we hugged, and we drew back, and he had tears in his eyes, and I had tears in my eyes, and he looked at me and said, "You're my best friend. That's why I'm alive." That's all I want to say.
One of my most special moments was when I turned round and looked at Alison walking down the aisle. And while I was looking at Alison, there was almost like a channel between Alison and I. In my periphery, I could also see all the people that were looking at me in either aisle, smiling and enjoying the experience that I was having looking at Alison. That was magical.
Well, I think mine was walking into the room, and I really was shaking. And I looked round and saw a number of faces. I felt like I needed to look round in the crowd to see people, because I needed their sort of support, you know, them looking at me, to sort of feel like I knew they were there with me, you know, and that sort of helped me walk down the aisle and made me feel better. And when I actually got to you and I said, "Are you all right?" And you said, "I am now that you're here." Can you remember saying that?
God.
Yeah. And that was really special.
I can remember my hands being really hot. I can remember I hold Alison's hand a lot. But I can remember holding Alison's hand and it being red hot.
And I felt like I didn't want to let go.
No, me neither. I thought that we were sort of holding each other up, weren't we?
Exactly.
Yeah.
It did feel like that. A lot of people have talked about the fact that we got to the end of the aisle and the ceremony started and then the sun just came out.
Yeah, when we turned around and walked away after we were married, the sun came out just as we were walking back down the aisle, and once all our friends were blowing bubbles towards us.
I know, that was amazing.
And the sun came out at the same time. That was magic.
And the readings. So you say about the readings, because you were actually really moved by my mum's reading, weren't you?
Yeah, when Alison's mum made the reading, I'm not really a big crier, but when Alison's mum made the reading, I did start to go a little bit. My eyes did well up. I nearly went. I nearly did a fill.
I mean, I actually felt it. In some ways, it made it more special, the fact that Phil cried.
Mm, definitely.
I was just really sort of blown away by it. And when Carl was speaking, I felt like it was actually Phil who was speaking through Carl. You know, sort of feeling about it,
definitely.
Wasn't there?
I can't believe how many people that I've hugged today and given a kiss to. It's unbelievable, like the feeling of goodwill.
Throughout
the whole day, it's been fantastic, hasn't it?
Absolutely amazing. And I think that's one, because obviously I didn't know whether I was going to make a speech, how I was going to feel, and this morning I just thought, I'm not sure there's any way I can actually make it. But I was really glad that I wrote it. And then when I got to it, I just thought, well, it's something I want to say, everyone wants to hear it. I'm just going to say it, and I really didn't feel nervous. And when I thought that I was going to cry, I just was open and just said, thought, no, it's all right, bear with me, I just need to compose myself. And that, you know, was really, really helped. And our first dance was a really special moment,
it was brilliant,
wasn't it?
Fantastic.
Because you were actually, I felt like you sort of got a bit nervy about it, didn't
did
you?
Oh, did you? Of course, yeah, absolutely.
But for some reason, I thought we're not going to be able to do it, we're going to be all over the place.
Yeah, and then when we started, after about three or four moves.
Exactly, because I looked around and thought, everyone's packing around, and I'd started showing off a bit, saying, come and watch our first dance, you'll be impressed. And thought, oh no, everyone stood around, what if it just goes absolutely to pot? But once we started, I just thought, well, if we go wrong, we just go back to the... to the beginning of the shimmy, it was great. We did really well. I wanted to do it again.
Yeah, I did. But I was hoping that we could do it.
I know that we finished and you were saying, oh, we'll do it again.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
It's just really funny.
I'll tell you one of the bits that I was looking forward to be honest with you, in the whole of the day, was a sort of aftermath. When people had gone home and there was just the people who were saying Rushpool Hall, we're just going to sit down, have a drink, have a chat, and sort of reminisce about the whole day. I've been really looking forward to that. And it's been wonderful. You know, people have been really complimentary.
Yeah.
How much they enjoyed the day. People who were that much more home.
I know. When the registrar said Mr. and Mrs. Rena.
Yeah, of course, yeah, absolutely.
Wasn't that just...
Yeah, magical,
it
yeah,
really was
absolutely.
Magical, wasn't it? Mm. Thinking husband and wife.
Right.
Yeah, a ring.
Oh, weird wearing a ring.
Well, I do wear my engagement ring a lot, don't I? But that feels very special.
Yeah, absolutely. Good night.
Good night.
Let there be cuckoos, a lark and a dove, but first of all, please let there be love. 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 Let there be love.